Raman, we're in front of the Kaman Kargo UAV. It's a medium size logistics UAV. Tell us about its capabilities.
Yeah, sure. So Kargo UAV is really designed to carry a medium payload. And by medium, I mean up to 800 pounds. So think about carrying, you know, a payload of 600 pounds, for example, 150 nautical miles, 160 nautical miles. And we designed it that way because we envision, much like, you know, the Marine Corps leadership is talking about expeditionary advanced base operations, for example, small teams could be distributed across hundreds of miles. So the ability to resupply and make real throughput, so at heavier payloads, is really what we were targeting. So we use a turbine engine so that we can get good power, we can get good range and good speed capability, so we can deliver that throughput.
And I imagine range is a big factor. What kind of times does it fly, and what kind of distances?
Yeah, so, well, you'd have to do the math, right? I mean, the VNE, or the maximum airspeed for this vehicle, is about 120 knots. We're going to validate that through flight testing later this summer, and we'll iterate to that. So, you know, a demonstrator is not going to achieve the maximum speeds that you might get out of the production model, but certainly we expect to hit speeds of about 100 knots during tests this summer. But that's the idea, right? If you're gonna transit long distances, you need something that has a little bit of speed. It doesn't need to be light speed, but it needs to be fast enough to be able to deliver a good amount of throughput in, for example, one period of darkness.
And how far does it have to go?
So we designed Kargo UAV to self-deploy out to 520 nautical miles. So the idea being that we realized that real estate on the amphib ships, on the naval, you know, on warships, and even on some commercial shipping that is going to support this EABO concept, we don't want to create a logistics burden, you know, with our logistics solution. So the idea might be, you might launch this from a rear area, fly this on a self-deploy mission to the EABO or the advanced base, and really you get it in the hands of the actual operators that are going to be using it. And then they simply reconfigure with a conformal pod or maybe a sling load, depends on what mission they want to execute. And these just run cyclic operations, you know, throughout the entire operation while those Marines are operating forward.
And I imagine you've designed this so that it works for amphibious Marines, not necessarily Marines doing counterinsurgency in Afghanistan as they were doing a few years ago?
Yeah, well, the big idea here is, you know, we focused on the Indo-PACOM theater, so we take a look at the geography there, and that's why we chose something that would give us a reasonable range, right? So short distances, there are certain applications for that, but yeah, you're right. I mean, so there are going to be times, we believe, when the ships have to remain outside of an enemy threat envelope, which is why we want to have a long range to be able to self-deploy to get to a forward area.
And how is it controlled? Is it autonomous or is it remote control?
It is autonomous. So we're partnered with a company called Near Earth Autonomy. They provide the autonomy solution on Kargo UAV. We have a long history with Near Earth. In fact, Near Earth worked on an ONR program called AACUS many years ago, $100 million program. And I'm happy to say we're able to carry that work forward on a real solution that could deploy one day very soon.
And you said it can carry up to 800 pounds?
Right.
How does it carry it?
So you can, there's a few options here, right? So the conformal pod is really what you see on the model. It's essentially a hollow composite pod that you can stack whatever equipment you need to in there. Alternatively, you can do an external long line application. For example, if you needed to deliver supplies into a jungle canopy area that didn't have a suitable, what we call a drop zone or a landing zone. We're even experimenting with some ideas on maybe aerial delivery. If you're familiar with the Joint Precision Airdrop System, maybe it's a GPS-guided parachute that guides the pod down to the, if you're in a mountainous area, for example, and you don't want to try to land equipment on a slope or something like that, maybe you use that. There's a lot of different ways that you can support this throughput, this sustainment.
And Raman, when you were in the Marine Corps, you were an Osprey pilot.
I was.
What's some sort of technology that is in this vehicle that you wish you had in the Osprey way back when?
Yeah, so here's the thing. Here's the interesting thing about Kargo UAV. I would answer that in an opposite way. I would say that this is actually a very simple machine. So I remember days when I would load up my Osprey, my $100 million Osprey, with pallets of water, for example, to deliver it to Marines that were only 10 miles away. So here we had a beautiful $100 million machine that was designed to go hundreds and thousands of miles and deliver troops into combat and bring them out. But we were using it in this way and exposing it to risks, you know, waiting in the landing zone, hoping that, you know, a bad guy wasn't going to drop artillery or mortars on you while you were unloading pallets of water. the idea here is you use something like this, a relatively low-cost UAV, to do that mundane, dirty, dangerous work and preserve your more exquisite platforms for those high-end missions that they were designed to do.
I see. And Raman, thank you so much for bringing us out.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure.